If you are too much embroiled with materialistic thoughts, then we won't have the proper mood when chanting also. So Prabhupada said, basically when we chant, we should hear. That's the basic principle of chanting. And it is a prayer, Krishna, please engage me in your service. I'm always engaged in Maya service. So we have to always chant in that prayerful mood. And to be in that mood, one must read Prabhupada's books and attend, you know, classes like this. And keep in touch with that philosophy, keep in touch with this thinking always. Then when we chant also. If we are too much embroiled with materialistic thoughts, then we won't have the proper mood when chanting also. So this is text from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 6, text 26. Yato yato nishchalati manas chanchalam asthiram tatas tato niyamyaitad atmanyeva vasham nayet. From wherever the mind wanders due to its flickering and unsteady nature, one must certainly withdraw it and bring it back under the control of the self. So basically the mind will go so many ways even when we are chanting. So there is offensive chanting, inattentive chanting. So we have to bring back the mind again. Okay, let me hear. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we have to hear what we are chanting. So to focus back on the words again. As we chant more and more, try to bring it back, bring it back, bring it back each time. The gaps between the attentive chanting, that means the inattentive chanting part, will reduce and reduce and reduce and come to a point where there will be no more gaps when one is chanting. That is called Kirtaniya Sadahari. That takes a while, you know. So we have to just regularly chant and chant and chant. No matter what, we just should chant. And okay, some other tips for chanting. Best to chant in the morning. Wake up early. So sleep early, wake up early, and finish all the rounds in the morning itself. Of course, after taking bath. Wake up, immediately take bath. Brush teeth, evacuate, take bath, start chanting. And finish as much as possible. If you can wake up like 3:30, 4, then finish chanting and then you can start your day. If you cannot, then you can still chant. Basically, over the whole day, you have to chant, but the concentration is more in the morning Brahma Muhurta time where there's no other distraction. Just chanting and nothing else. You don't have to check your notifications. Nobody's going to send you anything. So that is the best way. Otherwise, the whole day you have so many things to do. So, but still, you can, of course, take some time off and start to chant again.